Dobry dan.
Oh my God, there's already no air here.
Yes, let us open some windows.
Okay.
I closed my telephone. So, are you the starter?
Yes. Lepo zdrav vsem skupaj. Hvala, da ste se odzvali našemu vabilu. Danes smo vas povabili zato, da vam iz prve roke predstavimo dejstva v zvezi z plačno politiko v DUTB. Kot veste, je porevizijsko poročilo Računskega sodišča, ki je bilo izdano pretekli teden, ugotovilo, da je DUTB v 11 od 13 popravljalnih ukrepov izvedla ukrepe ustrezno, v 2 mora stvari še nadgraditi in podlage za to so že pripravljene. No, seveda vas zanima ta en ukrep, ki se nanaša na plače. V zvezi s tem ste nas ogromno spraševali in zastavljali vprašanja. Moram reči, da tudi kar nekaj napačnih interpretacij. Dejstev bilo in ravno zato smo vas zdaj poklicali, da vam pač predstavimo dejstva. In zato je današnji sogovornik tudi predsednik upravnega odbora, dr. Lars Nyberg, ki je pravzaprav pristojen za sklepanje pogodb med izvršnimi direktorji in upravnim odborom in on vam bo tudi podal informacije in potem nadaljevanje odgovarjal na vaše vprašanja in mu kar predajam besedo. Z nami je še prevajalec Tadej Reisner, ki bo vskočil, če bo treba kaj prevesti, drugače pa je predstavitev v angleščini tudi ponavadi. Lars, floor is yours.
Well, thank you, ladies and gentlemen of the press. My God, I didn't know there were so many here, but you are, and very welcome. I will give you some facts, and I'll be happy to answer questions afterwards. Now we have this, for a start, the question of compliance and what we hear from the Court of Auditors. When do you want to translate?
No, we are going to do the...
Okay, we'll do the hair. Great.
Lahko samo, mislim, je možno prevajati, ker imamo v integralu prevajamo
to, če... Zdaj smo že ugotovili, da vsi si želijo...
To vsake
ti
reče, ker v bistvu ne.
Ja.
Ampak zdaj je zelo pomembna tiskovna konferenca, če jo lahko prevaja, ker je to za gledalce pomembno.
Vedno je pomembna, ampak preprosto...
Razumete? In zakaj ne bi mogel prevajati? Mislim, zakaj ne more prevajati, če v slovenščini tiskovna konferenca lahko prevede to?
Ja, to smo že debato imeli.
Je to vi vedno rečete, vedno isto debato rečete, zakaj, če je človek tu? Če je gospod tu, lahko prevaja, prosim.
Večina premaga.
Večina, niste prašali večine, niste nikogar, to vi vedno rečete.
Vi ste šele drugič na novinarski...
Ne, ni res to. Zakaj ne more, če je prevajalc tu, zakaj ne more prevajati? Prosim vas, mislim.
Večina.
Okay. Ni res.
Brez prevajanja, ker tako pravi večina, poslušajte druge.
No, please, let us continue. So, the first statement here, which is important, is that nothing has been paid out from the BMC that is not in line with the policies from March and the policy that we had before then. So everything that is paid out is in line with those policies. And this is important. I repeat it. Nothing has been paid out that is not in line with the policies. The old and the new remuneration policy. Now, the details of the present contracts that are not, according to the Court of Auditors, in line with the present policy, those details are being changed. So, and will be presented in new contracts well before we have to deliver them to the Court of Auditors. And those new contracts will be available on the web page. So this issue of non-compliance is now a non-issue. It is solved, and it will be shown to you in due course. When all the auditors have, or the lawyers have looked at this, it'll be posted. And again, these details have nothing to do with the amounts having been paid out. They are irrelevant to the amounts paid out. There are details of other just details in the contracts. So compliance is now a non-issue. Now let's give you some facts on what has also been discussed: the payments of Mr. Monson, who sends his regards from London, where he is today trying to sell Slovenia and make good advertisement for Slovenia as an interesting place to invest. Mr. Monson's fixed salary has come down from 20,500 under the old policy to 17,000 under the new policy. You see that the blue one, 20,500 down to 17. That's the fixed salary before with the old and the new policy. Under the previous policy, set by the previous government, agreed with the previous government, there was a possibility of having bonus payments. And Mr. Monson got some bonus payments during the fall of last year and the first month of this year. And when we got the new policy, the old policy would finish, but the remaining bonus payments had to be paid out. And this is what you see happened in March. That's the second, the blue line there, 114,800. Now, if you had calculated that into the salary, and I mean, bonuses vary depending on the circumstances. But if you had taken that into that he should have had it regularly every month, his salary would be around 37,000. That is the 20 plus what's in the bonus. Now that is not a fixed salary; it's a salary that may vary. But this is where you find it, 37. So in essence, if you read here, his salary between the fall and now has come down from 37 to 17. That is more than 50% decrease in salary. This has been reported as an increase in salary, and how those calculations are done, I cannot say. But these are the facts. It's come down by more than 50%. Including the bonuses. In the new policy, as you may know, there is no bonus at all. So the present payments are again consistent with that. Okay. No, let's give them out. Janusz and Alish is non-controversial. You can have them if you like. Same kind of. Now, there's also Mr. Monson is a Swedish citizen. There is an EU regulation that stipulates that you can pay your social contributions either in your home country or in the country where you work. Now, this takes time for the authorities to handle. But when it was handled and ready for Mr. Monson, who started in August last year, then those contributions were paid. That's actually taxes. Mr. Monson receives them and he pays them straight into the Swedish tax authority. That's where you have the 92,977 and 49. And you can see that was actually paid out in the last row and then delivered to the authorities in Sweden. The bonus payments of 114,000, those were gross. So he received, as you can see, on the net down there, he received 73 out of those. So these are the facts. Now let me... I cannot read the papers here, as you know, but I get very good notices of what's in there. And of course, some false allegations have appeared, no question of that. There's just one I want to comment upon, and that is the connection to the old company quartz. There are no such connections whatsoever. And I'm a little surprised that it has appeared here. It was said in a paper that according to unofficial sources, there were connections with quartz. This, my friends, I would consider as non-professional. You can't say a thing like that without checking. Probably none of you did this, but it would be internationally considered very, very unprofessional to say according to unofficial sources and coming out with something that is completely wrong and could have been easily checked. Okay, this is the only negative thing I'm going to say, and you are free to question afterwards. Now, are they overpaid, these Mr. Monson and the others? Well, of course, if you compare to a nurse, they earn a lot more. And nurses are probably underpaid in Slovenia as well as they are in Sweden, so I no question about that. But is it a relevant comparison? If you compare, for instance, with the Lohonic Law, which is a law, you know, used for all the state-owned companies, which says that the management can earn five times the average salary of the company plus 30% in bonus. If we would have used that Lohonic law, the payments to the management here would have been higher. So we are below the Lohonic law, as we have it with the new remuneration policy. That's one. If you compare them with the bankers in the private sector, and if we recruit people here, we have to be able to recruit from the private sector, then they are equal or below, definitely not higher than in the private sector. If we compare with, on the international basis, with, for instance, the asset management company in Ireland or in Spain, we are much lower, much lower. And indeed, they have less complicated issues because they have very few companies to reconstruct. They have mostly real estate to take care of. So it's very difficult to see that these people are now overpaid. So my last point here is the question of is this a successful company? And if you read the press here, you certainly get the impression that this is a very unsuccessful company. And when I meet people in Parliament, they come with the most strange ideas of what we do, who we are, and how successful we are. But if you talk to the people internationally, if you talk to the IMF, to the Commission in Brussels, to the ECB in Frankfurt, to the EBRD in London, they all unanimously claim that this BMC in Slovenia is one of the few very successful asset management company that they have seen. We've been able to do exactly what is expected from us, taking over the assets, reconstructing them in a very successful way in a number of cases, and then also started selling these assets earlier than expected, and showing a good result for 2014 in doing that. Now results go up and down, so we cannot promise anything for 2015, but at least for 2014 we managed far above expectations, far above all international expectations. But still, this is little understood here. Are we cost efficient? Well, the cost, as you can see in the reports, are about 0.8% of the assets under management. This is very little compared to other asset management companies, and also other companies just taking care of assets in general without reconstructing them. So in spite of our big task of reconstructing, we have very low cost, 0.8 of what we have in our portfolio. Half of that 0.4 is due to staff, that's salary simply. So, we have, I think I'll stop there and let you go. I just, it's amazing that the concept of what we do, who we are and what we have done is so different when you read international institutional surveys rather than when you see what happens in the press here. So it would be great if you can help us to explain to the, in particular the Parliament, who have very peculiar sometimes ideas of what we do, that we actually are not as unsuccessful as people tend to think here. Thank you.
Tako, vprašanje, odpiramo razpravo, lahko sprašate v slovenščini, lahko v angleščini, dajmo eno vprašanje na novinarja, pa potem ponovimo kroge. Kdo bo začel? Izvoli.
Sicer je red, da nismo v telo poti dve stvari, zato bi po knjige, vsi pa delamo to že leta in leta in vsekako nismo neumni in znamo prebrati. V aneksu nikjer ne piše, da je gospod Manson upravičen do nagrad. Piše, da se mu plača za nazaj dvigne za 80%. Samo dva stavka sta, očitno se ga da razlagati na to veliko stvari, ampak načinov nismo da večem pokazati in ne, očitno vsi beremo na robo. Nikjer v aneksu ne piše, da gre za nagrado. Kot je omenil, da je Kotmanzom prvo nagrado dvije jeseni. Mesto je nastopil 1. augusta. Očitno je delal izredno dobro, da je bil recimo v dveh mesecih že so zaznali tako, ne, tako velik napredek, da je bil že upravičen do nagrade. To je gospod rekel, jaz ne bi se opet nagrade prišel na zboru. Ampak kar se tega aneksa tiče, je zelo jasno. Nikjer ne govori o nagradi, ne kaj je naredil, ne kakšni so bili uspehi, kriteriji za to nagrado, samo piše, fiksna plača se bo dvigne za...
Razumemo.
Hvala. In še toliko o... Verjetno je gospod Berek, da je kakšne druge časopise in gledate televizije in neimenovani viri se uporabljajo za to leta, desetletja in to prihod. Tako da... In vse, kar preverjamo in poročamo, vedno preverjamo tudi pri vas, če ne odgovorimo.
In vedno odgovorimo.
Včasih tudi na napačne naslove.
And sometimes,
Yeah, I'm sure that most of you do your job well. I didn't say anything else. I just gave you one example where it obviously had not been done. That's it. When you refer to the bonus payments, it is true that they are not in the appendices. They are in the old contract under the old remuneration policy, the one that came before the one in. So if you look in that contract, you will find the bonuses. It's not in the. What we now have agreed with the between the non-ex and the executives is that to either we take away these appendices completely and write a new simple contract that will be easy to see that it is in compliance with the remuneration policy. Change the appendices so that it's absolutely clear that they are in line with the remuneration policy. It all depends on what the lawyers say here, but the outcome will be that they are in absolutely compliance. Now, why did we have these appendices at all? That is, a reasonable question. The reason is that when we got a new policy in March, that was very quickly written and partly a political compromise. If you read the policy, you will see that it's partly internally inconsistent and also as judged by the board, the previous one and the present one cannot be used for recruiting a management if we ever need to recruit a new one, which of course we will have to. So the policy has somehow to be changed sooner or later. What we did then is to write appendices saying that for a time at least, everything will be paid out according to the policy. But if after some time we will revert to the old policy, unless we have a new one. And we were pretty sure we would have a new one because we have discussed that with the government, the board, all the non-executives have delivered a draft of a new policy to the government that would work when we have to recruit new people. That is still under discussion. But since we had to do something now in order to be compliant, we changed all these appendices. So we are now completely compliant, or will be within the next 2 weeks when the lawyers are through with this. I hope that's a answer to your question.
My question is, what is 114,800 euros?
Those are the gross payments.
In March he got additional. Yes.
Yes, that's the bonus payment specified in the previous contract, earned from the August up to February this year.
Why did you then sign the new annex? Because if that is in the first contract, you didn't have to sign the additional, which.
No,
the additional
just says that when the appendix is gone, then you revert after the appendix is out, which for Mr. Monson would be in December sometimes. Then you go back to the old contract, the old remuneration policy. You see, we hoped or discussed with the government to have a new remuneration policy by December, and then that would also overtake the the appendix. But to make it very simple.
It would be very interesting to translate that in Slovenian.
To make it very simple. That appendix is now gone.
Yeah, but it's 114,800 euros in March.
Well, that is the bonus payments related to the old contract. It has nothing to do with the appendix.
So this is not the number that is stated in the annex signed in 13th of February, which said that the fixed salary is actually increasing for 80%. It doesn't talk about bonus or something. It talks about fixed salary. It says the fixed salary is going to be 80% higher and it's going to be 3,690 euros.
Yeah.
But it doesn't say any bonus in not one word. It's just one page. But there is no bonus, you know.
No, but it's sort of the additional to the fixed salary that was bonus in the previous contract. But it is now completely. I mean, that would take 36,000 is an international salary, which is below what Mr. Monson had when we recruited him. He cut his wage by about 20% when we recruited him here, and still he had around 37,000. I mean, these are international salaries, I'm sorry. If you look at what they have in Nama and in Spain, that's it.
Okay, naslednje vprašanje.
Okay.
I have three questions. First,
so povezana.
Yes, of course. What is the maximum amount of bonuses that Mr. Monson is entitled to? What are criteria for those bonuses from that balanced scorecard? And how can you explain that Mr. Monson received 9,600 euros for travel allowance? Because according to the information on your website, travel allowance expenses are 4,800 euros.
Mr. Monson has no bonus payment now.
No,
none at all. So none of the executives have any bonus payments. So there are no criteria for any bonus payments in the present remuneration. There was in the previous one, but not in the present one. So that is completely gone. No bonuses at all have been paid out after March when the new contract or the new remuneration
and
policy came.
Why did he deserve that bonus in March?
It was a bonus from August, September, October,
but
all.
But on what basis?
But there was a contract. You have to live up to the contract.
What are criteria for that? I mean,
it was judged by the. He had a right to a bonus, and that was calculated on the results he had done, and he had certainly built this company. We had very good results for 2014. Again, as told you, better than expected internationally. We'd been able to essentially save Cimos from a complete bankruptcy into something that can be sold and is presently being sold. And we had also executed our first exit, as you remember, to the Merrill Lynch Bank of America.
Which is big Williams results since Monson was here from
William
was from December to the August, from August, which is 5 months, not the 12th.
This
he was entitled to all the results, no matter his team, all the other nine people, Mr. William that was before him. He was here 5 months, and all the other were also working, I guess.
Yeah, and they also
and
got.
He was entitled to, you know, like. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's that's true. I mean, you may think it's you may think that no one should have international salaries, but this is why we recruited him, and we are still convinced in the board, and so is the minister, that we need some international involvement in the management here. Yes.
So Mr. William also received bonuses in March or April?
No.
No?
No, he did not deserve it.
But
Škrube, Košič, the other executive directors?
Tu imamo tudi tabele za Škrubeja in Košiča. Vse skupaj bomo pripeli na spletno stran. Ne.
So just one son for yeah, 5 months,
kot vod, voditelj z mednarodnimi izkušnjami.
Pardon?
I said that he can also be alone here, since Škrube didn't get a bonus, Košič didn't.
Škrube got also a bonus. We can show that. And
he did?
Or didn't he? Did he not? I haven't checked that, really.
I think not.
No. Well, anyway, such was the agreement with Mr. Monson at the time, that he should have a bonus.
They all have bonus in their contract. We have all the contracts.
Yeah. But he deserved, yes.
And Mr. William had a bonus. So, you know,
but it's up to the board to decide whether they, this is why bonuses are not given automatically. You have to earn them, and then it was considered that this was the case. Definitely Mr. William were considered not to deserve any bonus.
So what about the other member of the board of the executive? So why didn't you change them? They didn't even got a bonus.
This is internal.
They're not working good. Just one is really good, the other two are not.
No.
Or you can just have Manson, you know, like if he's so good that.
Hvala. Še naslednje vprašanje?
First is, what is the average salary in BUTB? And the other one is, you said that the permanent salaries are totally in line with the government payment policy that was adopted in March. So why are you then going to totally change annexes? You said you are going to change annexes for the CEOs.
I mean, we're going to change or take away the annexes because they came from a very particular situation when we suddenly got a policy that was not in the long run possible to work with. And the old and the new board all agreed that this is so. This is how the appendices came up. Normally, there shouldn't be appendices to a contract like this. So we try to get away with those. And when it comes to Mr. Monson, there will be no appendix. That is for sure. Because we'll just rewrite the contract, so it covers all that is
so
needed.
You will make a new contract with all of them? There will be no...
We'll make new contracts with all the three. And when it at least comes to Mr. Monson, there will be no appendix. Whether there will be still an appendix needed for the other, that remains to be discussed with the lawyers. But anyway, if there is an appendix, they will be completely consistent with the policy.
Še 3500 bruto, vključeno z vodstvom. The average gross salary of naslednje vprašanje.
Did you get the answer?
No. The average salary without.
Aha, to bom pa pridobila še to informacijo. Ja.
Imam pa vprašanje glede kvalca. In sicer me zanima, odkdaj gospod Manson ni več povezan s kvalcem natančno in kaj ste ugotovili glede izplačil v letu 2013 in 2014. Predvsem to, ali so bila upravičena. Če so bila upravičena.
Upravičena v smislu
zaslužena. Ali so res mogli to delati, ali bi lahko to sami naredili?
If they were justified, the payments made to the quartz, the payments made to quartz,
the services,
whether quartz, the service fees paid to quartz were justified in 2013 and 14.
Well, yes, they were certified. Otherwise, the board would never pay them. And when it comes to Mr. Monson, he left quartz before he came here to take his position in August last year. This was a requirement by the non-executives, and we were, I think we have actually said this a number of times before, but I say it again, we required all ties to Quartz to be cut before he ever came here as the CEO position in August, and he did that.
In vprašujem zato, ker je računsko sodišče ugotovilo, da v bistvu niso bila veliko upravičena ta
izplačila.
Že lani.
Last year already. In 2013.
Well, I completely disagree, and it's very hard for the Court of Audit to say. Without the help we had from Quartz in the startup, under the very complicated year of 2013, and a little in 2014 when we took this over. Without this help, it would have been very difficult to establish this company and do all the due diligence, etc., that we had to make.
Four people at that time.
Yes, we were, as you know, how many were we? Four or five people at a time, and at the end of the year we were
10?
10?
Yeah.
So we heavily rested on consultants that turned out to be Quartz in this case. Could have been others, but they were good and did what we asked them to do.
Naslednje vprašanje, Vesna.
Jaz bi rada vprašala, 220.000 evrov je bilo izplačanih in nepojasneno, je bilo komu ste to izplačali in zakaj ste to izplačali? Pa natančno komu, kateri osebi in za kakšen namen?
What payments, you mean
the payments?
220.000 evrov je bilo nepojasnega.
In payments has never been explained. Kje
vprašanje?
Od januarja do maja so bili nakazani kateri fizični osebi ali podjetjem v tujini so bili od januarja do maja nakazani zneski 22.000, 23.000, 62.000, 71.000.
Oprostite, jaz ne morem pohiter številk zdaj in vsega tega. Bi vas prosil, če lahko upočasnite za jasno vprašanje, ki ga bi berete, jaz ga pa nimam pred sabo, upočasnite, da lahko primerno prevedem.
Kateri fizični osebi ali podjetjem v tujini so bili od januarja do maja nakazani zneski?
2013,
govorimo. 2000, ne, leto so bili.
No, 2015, yes.
Okay, what we pay abroad today is essentially to the foreigners participating here, and it's now. Well, in the beginning of the year, we were three in the board. Now it's me and Imre. Is he considered to be a foreigner? Yes, yes. So that he's paid in Hungary, and then we have Mr. Monson, and then we have two employees, as you know, Mr. Harjumpää and who else?
Kaspar.
Kaspar Oyasu. Yes. those are the ones being paid. And we do not have any foreign consultants, as far as I know, at the moment. So this will cover them all.
Pravi, to so zneski, ki ste njim oziroma vam izplačali.
That you have paid to them or to yourself.
To?
To you. That were paid to you, to these people that you just mentioned.
No, I just get my monthly salary. Is that what you mean? Or what? To, the,
I'm not
to
sure
you?
What
do you mean you?
Obrazite.
Well, can't we, I mean, we'll be happy to give you all the details on this whenever you like.
That's the problem. We have asked these questions
pisno,
in writing,
in smo dobili odgovor,
the answer that we got
da ne dajete, da ne dajete pojasnil za druge fizične osebe, razen za
zaposlene individuals other than Mr. Munson.
Well, you know what is paid to the board is all given on the home page, on the web page, because that's me and the other foreigners, and then you have the rest is what's paid to Mr. Yas and Mr. Haryampa. That's it. Nothing else is there.
They have international salaries.
And yes, and of course they have international salaries. Certainly, Mr. Haryampa was in. A specialist in the experienced specialist in this area. He has an international salary, no question. Yes, he's much better paid than anyone in the of the EDs at the moment.
Sem imela še eno podvprašanje od kolegice, ne glede izplačila Monsonu nagrado, ki jo je
prejel,
se
rekel, 14,000.
Zanima me, ali ste se za te anekse odločili prav zaradi vladne napovedi, da bo znižala plače. Ste to storili za
nalašč?
In s tem, če lahko še to, izigrali
vlado
ali
davkoplačevalce.
I mean, there is nothing of that. Which was paid out is paid out according to the old policy. Let me make that absolutely clear once again. And that policy was valid up to March this year. We had to honor the old policy, and we did. Now, the appendix was set there because we got a policy that we saw immediately needs to be changed sooner or later. So we just, since we had to be compliant, we didn't want to pay out more than was in the policy. We made these appendices saying that, look, we'll absolutely run according to the policy for until December or for the others in March, and by then we hope to have a new policy that we can discuss. There is no promise in doing this. We haven't paid out anything. It's just the appendix handling the question. Well, we all know that there must be a new policy, because the old one is not useful for recruiting or anything. I mean, the present one. So it has to be somehow adjusted. We pushed the question of adjusting it forward. But there was no intention to fool anyone. There was no intention to pay out anything outside the policy. And we have not done that. Let me be absolutely clear. We had no intention to do anything but act according to the law and according to the incomes policy. It's just that we realized that we need a new incomes policy, and this has been discussed with the government over the months, and we have just one draft coming out.
Je pa prejel gospod Monson to nagrado, jo je dobil.
he was paid his bonus. So that's what you're saying.
No, he was paid the bonus according to the old contract. Then we have a new contract with the appendix, and according to the appendix, nothing has been paid out. Nothing. So everything paid out is due to the old contract, nothing concerning the new contract.
Koliko ste vi dnevnik finance, tak imamo zdaj vrstni red?
You said that Mr. Halimpoma has a higher salary than the executive officers. Yeah. How high is it? And my colleague, she was asking about the transactions abroad around the 15th of the month when you have salaries and you're paying people. But I found some other transactions, let's say at the beginning of June you paid someone or something almost 93,000 euros abroad as well. Is that also person, or because normally you have salaries around 15, but then you have
no, there's nothing paid out except what we have shown. But isn't the 93,000 in June exactly what you have here? Yes, you can see the 93,000 in June was the what he paid in taxes to the Swedish government. The social contribution.
The salary of Mr.
Halimpa? The salary of Mr. Halimpa is not in detail revealed. For some reason in Slovenia, we don't give out the wages of employed people. In Sweden we do, everyone would know, but this is not so in Slovenia. We have talked about that and I don't mind. I would argue that we should, but well, not everyone in our staff agrees to this for some reason. So I shan't change. But I'll tell you, it is definitely, we have to pay him international salary. Otherwise he would go. And he's been instrumental in saving Siemens, which has meant a lot to this country.
Leonik?
Two questions. Is Mr. Halimpa entitled to bonuses? And the second question, you come from a corporate world. I'm sure you are aware of a relation between the stakeholders. I mean, and BMVC is 100% owned by Slovenian government. So Minister of Finance, Mr. Mramor, has said that he has demanded these corrections of your payment policy twice or three times. So why didn't you obey your owner?
Of course, we'll always obey our owner, we have been discussing how to do this in various ways.
But for 7 months.
But it takes time to work in the government. I mean, we are much quicker than the Minister of Finance, I can assure you that. we have been discussing this and how to solve it, and now it is solved. But there are various ways of doing it, and we've been discussing that. But since nothing has been paid out, it hasn't really mattered. The appendices have been, they say nothing until the striking day, which is December or March. So they are of no relevance until then. So we had this time to discuss and change. And in the end, we have. We have reached something, a draft to a new policy that may be useful in the future.
Is your opinion on...
And then we don't pay Mr. Halimpa any bonuses.
He has fixed salary.
We pay him at the moment a fixed salary, and he's employed, he's not a consultant, he has a fixed salary. Mm-hmm.
Just one question. Do other members of the board, non-executive directors, share your opinion on... ridiculousness of payment policy, and with you.
I wouldn't call it ridiculousness of You should never call a government document for ridiculous, but it's official. Read it yourself. You'll see that it contains contradictions and also things that are unclear, and things like Mr. Monson, yeah.
And Mr. Balot, Mr. Sironik, and Mr. Simonetti all share your opinion on this one.
We are definitely, in all respects, agree on this. This is why we together have written a new policy. Mm-hmm. There are no differences in view within the non-executives here. And because we all have to, the day we have to recruit a new management, that will be our responsibility. And a new management cannot be recruited with this policy.
What specifically is wrong with this new remuneration policy
that it will not be competitive abroad?
The one we have today,
yeah,
is... doesn't even stand up to the Lahonic law. That is, there are no possibility of variable payments. It's just a fixed payment, and that is fixed by the government not by the non-executive directors in the board, which is very unusual. It actually says exactly what the executives should have. Normally the government or the owner will fix the salaries of the non-executives, and the executive salaries will be fixed by the, or set by the non-executives. This is very unusual that they went and determined these salaries of the executives directly in the policy. That in itself makes it impossible to recruit internationally, or I would say even from the private sector. And there's also no bonus, no way of having a variable payment, not even the 30%, which you find in the Lahonic law.
Another thing, what would the wages be according to Lahonic law, in your opinion?
Well, what did we have? 3.5 times 5 is the maximum, plus 30% possible variable payment of bonus. So then you can do it for yourself. And you will see that it's even Mr. Monson is a bit below that.
Še vprašanje iz dela, potem pa počasi zaključimo.
In the present policy?
Yes.
In the present policy, there is no variable policy.
In the present annex that is valid for the Mr. Marson and also Mr. Stuber.
Yeah, but it's not valid, you see. It's not valid until in December or March, respectively. Then it may become valid if it's not changed, and now it will be changed. But it has no implications.
After this expires, so December 1st of December, then there is no possibility that Mr. Manso will get a bonus payment for this period now?
No, that not even today it is a possibility.
Okay. Strenkal, včeraj se stanek s ministrom Mramorjem, kaj so se v bistvu dogovorili, je bil Mramor zadovoljen s
pomislili in bilo tudi, kaj bo Mramor with your explanations, and was there any talk of discharge, of, sorry, not discharge, dismissal in members?
No, I mean, the owner, that is in this case the state or the Minister of Finance, they can change the non-executive directors. They cannot change the executive directors. That's the job of the non-executives. So things like that are never discussed with the minister. The minister is, he observes the rules of this, for sure. His profession.
Were
the results of yesterday's meeting, what was the outcome? Is the minister satisfied with your explanations that you have given him?
They have understood the details of this. I think they were actually understanding it much earlier, but we have now delivered the figures, so they see exactly this table, when it was paid out, why it was paid out, and what the legal grounds for paying it out. So we didn't have any discussions on that at all. That was clear from the beginning. We have
what were the demands?
Were there any additional demands made by the ministry from the BMC?
just that we would try to make this clear to everyone, and that this is why we have this meeting. And also that we should try to make it clear in Parliament. So we will have a session in Parliament next week where we talk to the parliamentarians.
There has been no talk about the dismissal of the board of directors?
Not with the board of directors. If there had been talk, if you hear something in Parliament or whatever, I don't know, but it's never been up with the with us. You know, we changed to, we got three new members in March, and this board is working very well, and we are all aligned on all important issues. So, and we've heard nothing from the ministry of wanting to do another change.
Another question.
Do you see any do you see any reason why you should resign from this this position?
No. Do you?
Well, we have several questions because of that. Apparently, everything wasn't clear, wasn't transparent.
I think everything is completely transparent. We now, you could find it, we'd answer it. It is transparent, it has been transparent, and it's been accepted by the government. We haven't paid out anything we shouldn't pay out. We paid according to the contract and nothing else. And there is, we are, actually we consider us to be now let's say we'll be compliant in all respects, even with the interpretation of the Court of Auditors. We may make other interpretations, but we'll be sure that we are in line with the interpretations of the Court of Auditors, so that everything will be set by them. And there is no bonus payments that are ever covered. We haven't paid out anything to anyone that is not in line with the present policy. Why should we do that? I mean, that's definitely so. Yeah.
I have two questions. In that paper from February, it says that it's bonus, but it says increase of the salary. The date is from August till the end of June. You actually
August. August.
From August to the 30th of June. I can show you. So, but.
You're mixing the old and the new contract. Take the old contract and the new contract with the appendix. And the new contract with the appendix says that if we come, in that case, to December and there is no new policy, we will revert to the old policy. Now, that will never happen. In that, so the
but
appendix is nullified.
The paper from February, it says, on 13th of February, he can get 80% of the increase of salary from August till the end of June. You actually paid this bonus
from August till the end of March.
Yeah.
But he didn't get it from April till the end of June.
Of course not, because then we had a new contract.
Okay. Yeah. And the other question, he's the only one that has a clause in his contract, the first one, that he can work for someone else, if that's not a competition, which we don't have in Slovenia, without, you know, consent or whatever. Who is he working for? Because
I can tell you that if you like to know. He's working for his wife. Because his wife has a big, not a big, she has a company selling furniture, and he's in the board of that company.
Because he's the only one that has the clothes.
Yeah, and that's why. Okay,
but this is the best furniture shop in Stockholm, so if you ever come there, you should go and visit her.
IKEA.
No, it's not IKEA.
But now we're going to all agree to the new contract. Because there is
yes, yes. Okay. There will be nothing will be left in terms of uncertainties there. And I'll personally see to this that this is the case. We have to deliver it to the Court of Auditors within 3 weeks. So before then, this will be ready and posted on the homepage.
Yeah.
If the government is going to stick with this new policy of payments,
the one we have now,
after December, is your team of directors and you personally still willing to do this job?
We'll do the job, certainly. we'll do the job certainly after that. Oh yes, we have. That's part of the deal with the executive. That they will continue under the new or the present incomes policy, but we'll try to get changes in the present one that will make it possible to recruit people in the future. That's really the main thing, and that's what the non-executives are asking for the government, because the government will ask us to recruit new people sooner or later, and then we cannot do this with the present policy. That is even below the Lahonic law when it comes to. Yeah. So
when will this new contract again in force? In the first of December or before?
Immediately.
They are already in 3 weeks.
They will when we write the new contract, they will be from now on.
But they are not signed yet.
They are not signed yet because Mr. Monson is in London, and
they are already prepared.
They are ready. There are details, but you will get to see them.
Forgive me for not understanding, why does Mr. Monson need almost 10,000 euros for travel allowance? Does he travel a lot? I mean,
No. It's very simple. It's not 10. This is the half because he pays. This is pays its cost.
5,000 euros for.
No, it's 9 is 4.
4,800.
5,000 this is. He goes home over the weekends. I mean, if he couldn't do that, his wife would not permit him to be here at all. This is.
Evo, to je pa zadnje vprašanje.
Zanima me, kako je mogoče, da tudi če iz krivdnih razlogov.
On the grounds of wrongful acts, that
he is still entitled to the same
in the amount of 6 monthly salaries.
I mean, this is regulated by ordinary law. If he, if he's doing irregularities, if he would be dishonest, if he would do something criminal, he would not be permitted severance, whatever it says in his contract. So this just follows the ordinary Slovenian law.
Hvala lepa za vašo pozornost.
se vidimo naslednjič.
Lahko tudi prosojnice dobimo.
Ja.
Prosojnice
bomo na spletni strani objavili.
Thank you for staying so long, in spite of the air.
Is this furniture from Mr. Manson family company?
No. That's an NK, you know, the big store in Stockholm, the big warehouse, and she has the furniture department there.
Yeah.
It's too expensive for me to buy that, but it's very nice.
Čeprav vsi so takrat normalni ljudje, samo ti ne vem, ampak se bomo že uredili, tako kot smo zadnjič.
Thank you.